Good evening, I'm Padmaja Joshi, and that will be the big focus on our 6 p.m. bulletin. Call it vigilante politics, call it empowering the Aam Aadmi, but Delhiites have reacted overwhelmingly to Arvind Kejriwal's anti-corruption helpline. The morning after the announcement, the helpline in a few hours recorded thousands of calls. The Delhi government's anti-corruption helpline number went live today at 8 a.m. It began working from room number 211 in the Delhi Secretariat, right next to the Chief Minister's office. What you're seeing right now are images of that very control room where all your calls will be received. 11 officials serving and retired police personnel have been deployed to take these calls. While launching the anti-graft helpline, Arvind Kejriwal asked Delhiites to complain and help trap the corrupt through sting operations. The AAP has promised that it will act within 24 hours.
Number of seats today were 15. They were increased to 15. We started with 10 in the morning. पर जब देखा कि पहले ही एक घंटे के अंदर 200 कॉल्स आ गई तो तुरंत 15 सीट्स कर दी गई और चैनल्स जो थे लाइंस 30 कर दी गई. कल ये बढ़ा के 60 चैनल और 30 सीट कर दी जाएंगे. आज 3 बजे तक 3904 फोन कॉल आए थे, उसमें 824 फोन कॉल्स अटेंड हो पाए और 53 सीरियस केसेस थे which could translate into sting operations.
In keeping with his promise of anti-corruption, Chief Minister of Delhi Arvind Kejriwal yesterday set in motion an anti-corruption number. It's a helpline number where citizens can in fact call and report cases of corruption. Citizens will also be trained on this helpline number to in fact sting corrupt officials. Citizens will be taught as to how they can in fact nail officers who are perhaps seeking bribes or deliberately delaying any administrative process. So in keeping with the promise that the Aam Aadmi Party had made of anti-corruption, it is in this very corridor, in a room in this very corridor, that the control room for this anti-corruption helpline is in fact operational as of yesterday.
But Kejriwal's call for citizens to turn into watchdogs is raising many eyebrows. Many are questioning its feasibility. Many wonder whether Mr. Kejriwal is now asking people to circumvent authorities. The Aam Aadmi Party, though, says there's nothing wrong with what people are calling vigilante politics.
दुनिया की सारी mature democracy citizen participant हैं. अमेरिका चले जाइए, आप कहीं भी चलाइए, जहां भी डेमोक्रेसी ठीक ठाक काम कर रही है वहां ऐसे ही विजिलेंट सिटीजन्स हैं जो फोटो भेजते हैं, जो आपको इन्फॉर्म करते हैं, और उसी से टेररिज्म रुकता है, उसी से गुड गवर्नेंस आती है, उसी से क्लिंजिंग आती है करप्शन के खिलाफ. तो हम इसके लिए तैयार नहीं थे. जैसे जब हम गए लोगों से पूछने के लिए सरकार बनाए या ना बनाए, तो मीडिया को भी और पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज को भी, पॉलिटिकल आउटफिट को बहुत आश्चर्य हुआ, ये क्यों जा रहे हैं. हमने तब भी कहा भाई एक बड़ी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी है जो 10 जनपद से पूछ के काम करती है, दूसरी पार्टी है वो नागपुर से पूछ के काम करती है, तीसरी सुप्रीमो से पूछती है, चौथी हाईकमान से पूछती है. हमारे माई बाप आम आदमी है, उन्होंने बनाए. अगर हम उनसे पूछ रहे हैं तो आपको दिक्कत क्या है. हमने तो कभी नहीं कहा कि प्रधानमंत्री बार बार 10 जनपद की तरफ क्यों देखते हैं.
What could be worrying critics of the Aam Aadmi Party style of governance is this. In Rohini, volunteers tried to take over a community center by force. In Ghaziabad, instead of alerting the police, AAP volunteers raided a kerosene dealer who had allegedly hoarded fuel. Minister Raki Birla used threatening language, allegedly against government officials at a night shelter. Delhi's health minister Satendra Jain dismissed existing hospital management societies, replacing it with Aam Aadmi Party volunteers who are conducting inspections without formal orders. And this prompts us to ask some questions. Is the AAP now trying to circumvent existing institutions in the name of empowerment? Is the party also trusting its own volunteers more than that of the government machinery? And could giving such power to people actually lead to misuse and harassment?